Alrighty, well, I'm gonna jump into it here while we're waiting for Fergcraft and for the TheDarkPreacher to connect up and turn down the sound here a little bit. Now, first, let's just see if the server's going. I've been having some server issues lately. Yeah, there's Ferg joining. Hey, Ferg.
Hello.
I would name that.
Sorry, what's that?
Oh, in my headphone cords, I have a giant gnat. Oh. But I did not realize when I plugged it in.
Hate that. Alright, I'm just hoping that the server starts up okay. Oh, yeah, looks good. Last couple of times, it was just kind of jammed. So we've got some Minecraft issues here at a low level. Hey, Atanchi, how is your writer's channel been going? I haven't had a chance to drop in for a few weeks, but I was really enjoying that.
Hi, Atanchi.
All right, well, it is 8 o'clock Pacific time, and let's go ahead and start this up. We're going to go ahead and launch the Life
this
in the
Buffer. This is Vaygrim's chance. Welcome to Life in the Buffer.
November was a... All right. Well, here we are at... Vaygrim's Chance Season 4 Life in the Buffer Live. I've got Fergcraft with me. I've got Fergcraft with me. Go ahead and say, hey, Fergcraft.
Hey, Fergcraft.
Thanks for that. And this time, I'm going to try using the push-to-talk instead of just having my mic open all the time. Because, Ferg, I watched your... Let's Plays, and I watched Dark Preachers, and I was sad to hear that there was a whole lot of me. I was sitting here listening to Dark Preachers Let's Play, and I heard mostly me, and Dark Preacher was actually a little bit quiet, but I was plenty loud in Dark Preachers Let's Play, so I'm going to see if Push to Talk can fix some of that. So, and by the way, Ferg, Atanchi says hello. So Atanchi, you kind of had a rough November, Brit, so you're jumping back into it. Because I actually thought that was a pretty cool channel. You guys had some really good rapport there, and that's...
Sleeper doesn't sleep through his alarms tonight.
Yeah, I did see that he was online, the Dark Preacher, so hopefully he does show. Yeah, so Tanchi, I'd really enjoy that because of that rapport that you seemed to strike with your chat room. There was just so much back and forth.
Hey, and, he's a mod. He's not even in Discord.
And, genuine conversation going on back and forth. It was almost like sitting down at a
coffee shop. Does this mean I'm going to be in charge again?
And, just listening to the conversation back and forth as you've got these artists, you know, doing their thing. It was pretty cool. It seemed unique to me, anyway. I'm not sure how much of that is going on, but it seemed pretty unique to me, anyway. But, yeah, it was really good. I really appreciated it, so... I don't know, whatever that's worth. So, Ferg, what do we want to work on tonight?
I have no idea.
I think I'm not gonna like this push to talk thing. That's what I think.
I'll turn it off. It doesn't bother me.
I think I'm gonna switch over really quick.
Oh.
All right, now I'm back on voice again.
You see who's stacking us now?
Yeah, I saw that. We've got an intruder in the chat room. We may need to bring a moderator in to take care of him. Yeah, so Itanchi, I don't know, is there much of that? Because I really hadn't seen that. You know, I try to pop into your streams whenever I can anyway, just because I think you're a real... You know, I think you've got a talent for that, so I enjoy watching that. And I hadn't really seen too much of the writing scene in Beam, or on Twitch, for that matter, but is that a thing? Because, I mean, you were really kind of the first exposure I'd had to that sort of thing. Got CA Samuels. Craig Plays is also in the server tonight. One of the Bromigos. Representing the Bromigos this evening. Okay, many on Twitch. Alright, I hadn't seen that. Cool. Mallrat, welcome, welcome. Thanks for joining in. Appreciate it. This is a tough time slot. It's late. You know, you've got the East Coast is turning in for the evening, and so you just get pretty much the West Coast here, and a little bit of Central is all. So there's not a lot of people not as much of an audience as there is earlier on in earlier time slots. But I'm on the Pacific Coast, so it's really the only opportunity for me to stream. Because I've got a whole real life with work and family and everything, so by the time I finish my work day and then do all the family things with, you know, dinner and conversation and all that kind of stuff, this is pretty much it for me. So it is what it is, and I kind of, you know, enjoy doing it, and I just understand that I'm not going to have 100 people in my chat room, because that's just the way it is. Craig Plays, you see that, Ferg, in the chat?
Yeah.
Because we had to move, we had to change dimensions, and so now his slime farm is no longer a slime farm. It's gone dry.
It has broken.
Yeah.
That's hilarious.
Well, here's one thing that I was working on. Is I've been going through and doing some subtle improvements on our power supply. It generates enough RF for us when we need. I mean, it kicks out 600 RF per tick, which is fine for us for right now. But we're not actually producing enough canola oil to keep it running nonstop if we had to. And so I was doing a few little experiments here to see what I can do to make it work a little more efficiently.
Yeah.
And
oh yeah, the greenhouse glass on top, that'll make it go faster.
I think so. So I was actually over here is a little 3x3 of fertilized dirt from what is it? Random Things, I think. And that's what's over here. And then over on this side, I've just got just three pieces of the greenhouse glass from Actually Additions. And I was kind of comparing the two to see, which would do better. Over here we've got the greenhouse glass plus earthworms, right? And over here we've got just the fertilized dirt, because I don't think that the earthworms actually do anything with fertilized dirt. I think they only use the vanilla dirt.
Well, I wonder if we put that glass over the fertilized dirt, if it'll compound.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I think so. So I did a quick little test here anyway, and it was pretty much the same. I think, you know, when it comes to the first harvest to market kind of a thing, the greenhouse glass came in just barely ahead of the fertilized dirt, but not by much, and it could have just been, you know, the random number generator kind of a thing.
Yeah.
But yeah, so the ultimate would be both. I tell you, the greenhouse glass is a lot more difficult to make than the fertilized dirt is, because the fertilized dirt is just bone meal and zombie flesh, and that's about it, really.
Yeah. But we could swap out for the fertilized dirt right away, and then slowly add the greenhouse glass as we get stuff.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, so this is one project anyway, because I think that this fertilized dirt is going to get us more than vanilla dirt plus earthworms will. I think it's definitely going
to help. Well, I just did the earthworms, because then we don't have to have water going down to the void.
Oh yeah, sure. Oh yeah, no, I totally get that. It was perfect for the time, but now I think I'm wanting a larger harvest.
Want more.
I want more, always more. Yeah. more than just what the earthworms can get us. So that's okay. One little project.
All right, I can work on that.
Yeah,
you could be in charge today.
I've got some stuff here from when I was doing experiments before. So here's like some bones and some rotten flesh, and here's some dirt too. And do you,
give me your crap.
Yeah, there you go. I wasn't gonna say that because it sounded from your tweet that you were actually kind of dealing with that already today. But yeah, okay, if it fits, wear it, so to speak.
I'm not gonna wear crap. I'm sorry. I like you and all, but no.
But no, you gotta draw the line somewhere. I appreciate that. Boundaries. Yeah. Boundaries are a good thing.
Boundaries.
Yeah. So I may, maybe expand out our capacitor bank. I think give us just some increased storage. This is doing all right. We've got a couple of full tanks of canola oil, but I just think canola doesn't kick out enough for us.
I don't think personally. So either. Look, more dirt.
Oh, is there some here? Coffee beans. I always confuse the coffee beans and the canola because they just look so much. They're both just piles of brown in the inventory. You know? This, I can tell there's already going to be a theme for this episode of Life in the Buffer, right?
Piles of brown.
We're going to have to figure out how to keep this out of the gutter or the sewer or whatever.
Too late. I've got my title.
Too late. I did have to reset the Ender IO connector for our auto sieve. It had broken, so Ender IO is still kind of giving us some problems.
Yeah. Same with the other stuff here.
The other stuff? What other stuff?
Actually, addition or the stupid network thing Yeah, pretty much.
I have no idea what you're talking about. But hey, did you see the wireless storage thing that I set up for us over here? Come over here.
No, I didn't.
On our little, it's a drying rack, but it's our tool rack. So right here,
yeah.
If you pull that off the drying rack, it gives you wireless access to everything that's in our refined storage system.
Ooh, I have the power.
And it's got pretty good range. Over here is the antenna for it right here, and I've got it set up with up to about 24 blocks away. I think is what the range is. So.
I don't mean to alarm you, but it looks like something else from this particular angle.
Don't. Why you gotta go there, man? Why you gotta go there?
Because
it's an antenna.
Somebody's got to.
It looks like a torch. It looks like an aqua version of a redstone torch is what it looks like. And anything else that you think it might look like is entirely in your head, Ferg.
Well, we already knew this.
Yeah.
Happy to see me.
I did find a little bug the other day in the X-Compressum auto compressors.
Yeah.
They we've got stuff getting piped into it from the auto sieve because it will basically batch up and turn them into cubes of things. But the problem is that the input to these auto compressors, if the input grid is full, they will accept things into the output grid.
Oh, that's weird.
Yeah, and so.
That is a bug.
Yeah, that is. Unfortunately,
that can lead to bad things.
Yeah. Well, it wasn't too bad. It's just that we ended up with like uncompressed dusts in the crate here, and so I was just I was just pulling my hair out trying to figure out why it is that this wasn't working. And I consider myself to be pretty adept with Ender IO and routing and whitelists and filters and whatnot, but I just could not get it to work, and it was just driving me crazy. And then as I was working with it, all of a sudden I would notice that stuff would pop into the output side of the compressor periodically, just really quick, and then would disappear. And so I started putting the pieces together and did some tests, and sure enough, when the input is full, anything that goes into it ends up coming into the output, and then it gets piped away. And so I went onto the GitHub page for this, and sure enough, it had been discovered fairly recently, and then the most recent version of X-Compressum actually has a fix for it, but we don't have that version yet. Hopefully soon. So I'm thinking Dark Preacher may be a no-show.
Yeah, I guess you get to be in charge this time around.
Oh, that's a scary thought, actually. Also on the mob farm over here, your mob farm, I added a filter for the to filter out bows and to filter out visors, so they just go straight into the trash.
Okay, that's fine. Well, we were gonna make that thing to autocraft them into full so we could smelt them down.
Well, if you've got a thought for how to work that, I've honestly never worked with that Wired. That's the name of the mod, right? Wired, is that what it is?
I think that's what it is, yeah. Or it's.
Yeah, Wired. That's
whatever creature was working on.
Yeah. So I've never worked with it, so I'm not sure what our opportunities are for how to deal with all the stuff that comes out of it. I just know it's more stuff that we can ever use, so I just kind of piped it straight out to the trash can.
Well, it's...
No offense, Mallrat.
Well, it has nothing to do with that stuff.
Yeah.
All that. It's actually what Preacher was working on down below, because you can make... the Talisman of Repair, like a machine that does that for the armors.
Yeah, right. He mentioned he wants to set up one of those, yeah.
Yeah, so then we could have full armor and then, like, melt the gold armor and the iron armor and that stuff.
All right. I'm a big fan of that. Sounds good to me.
All right. I have no idea how to do it.
Oh. Anyway, I just want to let you know that I'd added that over there.
Oh, that's fine.
I think what was happening is that it was all full of all that stuff. You know, you get, 10 different versions of a pair of visors or something. And so it was all full of that stuff. And all the stuff that we wanted to keep was on the floor and would end up just de-resing, basically.
Well, that's fine for now, because then we can fix it later.
Yeah.
Now I gotta figure out where you put all the stuffy stuffs.
What do you mean, what stuff? What stuff are you looking for?
Oh, never mind. It's easy enough to tell what is what.
Oh, yeah, it's just this little 303 in the corner. That's all.
Yep.
Everything else is all as it was.
Yep. So I'm going to start replacing all this.
Cool. Yeah, and then we could either cover it in glass, and then we could have, like, the ultimate canola farm.
Yeah.
That'd be pretty cool. That was pretty wise of you to put an extra layer of cobble down there. Oh, wait, there's still some missing, though. Okay, I take that back.
I didn't do that.
I was all prepared to give you massive creds, and then I saw the holes in the floor.
Well, too bad. I didn't do it anyway.
It's not yours anyway, okay. Alright, I think I'm going to make some more storage here for us. The capacitor bank.
Oh, I bet it's like that because somebody was running piping underneath it all.
Oh, I see. So you're trying to blame it on me now.
Yeah. That's how the cookie crumbles.
Yeah. I guess. I did change the piping around over here by the cobble generator and smeltery, too. I just kind of went through the other night. It was kind of quiet on the server, and hey, Greater C! Thanks for the follow. Appreciate it. It was kind of quiet on the server, and so I went through and just cleaned up a bunch of the pipes, when you first install stuff, they're all, zigzagging everywhere and twisting around each other. So I went through and just cleaned a lot of that up, so it's all nice straight lines now. I'm not going to say I'm OCD, but I do appreciate tidy infrastructure, especially when you've got multiple people, maintaining it. It makes it much easier to troubleshoot when something's going wrong.
Oh, now I see what it was. It was I had them underneath just the farms themselves, the original farms.
Oh, okay.
That's what it was. So I just gotta add some cobbles. It's fine.
Basic capacitor bank. Hey, Mallrat says that it sounds like iChun is doing a 1.10 release of Morph. Wow.
Yay!
Yeah, Vaygrim was...
Return of the coop.
Oh, hey, we got the Dark Preacher showing up. He just popped into the server. I don't know if you heard in Vaygrim's... Hey, we thought you were going to be a no-show. Actually, Ferg thought you were going to be a no-show. I told them that you were going to be here, that that's just not like you.
Well, I had to get a sandwich real quick. Blood sugar dropped real fast.
Mm. Oh, understandable. I know all about that. Yeah.
So, what are we working on?
I'm making the farm better.
Yeah, Ferg is adding fertilized dirt to the farm so we can increase our canola yield.
Greenhouse glass is employed.
I was doing a little test to see which would be better, the greenhouse glass or the fertilized dirt. So actually it's greenhouse glass plus earthworms versus fertilized dirt is what it is. Because the fertilized dirt, I don't think the earthworms work on fertilized dirt.
I have no idea.
Yeah, I'm going to try one and see. Drop one in, that'd be kind of cool. It'd be like an extra buff for it. That'd be kind of cool. Alright, where was our... And so Ferg's doing that, and I thought I would add another capacitor bank to our power storage. Just to give us some extra storage capability. Oh, I'm gonna be short on redstone.
Doesn't look like the worms will place on the fertilized dirt.
Yeah, alright, I kind of thought as much.
Oh well, it's fertilized dirt, who cares?
Well, we want every bonus we can get, right?
Yep.
Wow, 37 blocks of redstone. We have no redstone shortage. Well, that'd be cool, Mallrat, if Aichan does indeed pick up Morph. I know a lot of people really like that mod.
Well, he's the original creator of it.
Well, yeah, I get that. But I also know that...
What do you mean pick it? You mean pick it, get
yeah,
back
I mean,
to...
Yeah. Well, pick it back up again as in you make it work for 110, port it over to 110.
Yes. I do enjoy that mod, too.
Well, a lot of people like it. And then in Vaygrim's stream, he was talking about with maybe working together with Morvalera to do a chicken pack.
Oh, that'd be fun.
Yeah, sort of. It's all farm-based and chicken-based. Which, yeah, sounded like a lot of fun. But, of course, that is dependent upon being able to run around as a chicken, which is exactly what Morph does and nothing else does right now.
Yeah. Without without too many restrictions. I mean, there's still restrictions.
Well, sure.
All right. So, fertilized dirt and the greenhouse glass is working together pretty good.
Oh, yeah. It should, yeah.
Yay, double the stuffs.
Yeah.
So we need more of this.
All to things. In maybe
Still
you guys know this.
Hole.
In the refined storage, I can click on something to download the recipe to the grid, right? But then if I wanted to make like four of those, is there a way to tell it to make four? Because right now I just grab one and it just produces one for me and then I have to start all over again.
No idea.
All right.
Now, what are you trying to make?
Oh, so like for example, I want to make a capacitor, right? So I click on the recipe for the capacitor, and then I hit the little plus sign, and it downloads the recipe to the crafting grid, right? So now I'm looking at it, and I can just grab it from the crafting bin. But I just grabbed one. Now, what if I wanted to actually get like four of them and not just one, right? I remember in logistics pipes,
well, then
I could
go
actually
over to the pattern grid.
Yeah, I could pull out the ingredients and keep it in my inventory, for example, right? And that would work. But if I just want to pull everything out of the crafting grid, like in logistics pipes, I could just tell it I wanted to make 10, and then it would pull the necessary ingredients to make 10, right? No way to do that, as far as you know?
Hang on.
Right, so I say move items, and here's one. And then there's no other buttons here. I can rotate, I can balance, I can clear it, but that's it. Maybe if I shift on it or something? No, I still just grab one. It seems like it should be able to do that, like they should be, you know? Because it's easy enough, everything's all right here. It seems like it should be able to create more than one at a time, as long as you've got, you know, the inventory for it, of course. Huh. All right, I thought maybe I was just missing something here.
Well, you can teach it by going to the pattern grid,
yeah.
Putting it on a pattern.
Yeah, you can. Yeah, sure, you can do that. Yeah.
First off, we need. Where everything go? Where did our import go? Oh, you moved it. Okay.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I think just as you were logging in, I was telling Ferg that I went through and cleaned up the infrastructure here. Made things nice straight lines. Yeah, there's our input up here.
Somebody likes nice straight lines for some odd reason.
I do, actually. Well, especially when you got multiple people, you know, using the area, it's a whole lot nicer. It makes it easy for troubleshooting and finding things. And
okay, so I've got the 34 blocks of redstone, and in they went. So,
yeah, okay.
Let's see here. Just type in redstone in the regular grid.
Okay.
You'll see one redstone dust that says craft.
Sure, right. Oh, and yeah, I get that. You could actually make a recipe and have it auto-craft that recipe. I totally get that. And with that, yeah, if, for example, I saw that you had actually programmed in a recipe for the meshes, right? So I can type mesh, and there it says craft, and it's going to ask me how many I want. And that's totally cool. But in logistics pipes, you could basically do that for anything. So like when you see the recipe, and then you move the recipe over to the logistics pipes crafter, the little grid that you get when you're crafting a recipe in refined storage where it asks you how many you want, you would actually get that grid for any recipe in logistics pipes. I was just wondering.
Sorry, I got distracted. There was a text thing.
Yeah. Well, I think it just doesn't do it. That's all. I was just wondering if I was missing it, because I haven't used refined storage all that much. But I think that it just doesn't do it. I wouldn't call it a failing mall rat, but it would be a cool feature. It was something that I didn't realize how much I used in logistics pipes until it wasn't there for me. And it's not that bad. It's still a whole lot better than having to drop in individual ingredients. I mean, it's kind of like one of those first world problems, right? All right, where do I want to put this? I think I want to move this. The atomic reconstructor, I can just pick that up, right? There's, I don't have to use anything special to move that. It's not like...
No, you can just break it with a pick.
Buggy or anything. It's not going to crash the server.
No.
All right. Famous last words. No, it's safe.
I was just going to use that.
All right. I was trying to find just a nice spot to put the extra cell here for the capacitor bank. Looks like I'm just trying to see what else is right here. We've got some insulated redstone that's right there, and power's right there, so I should be fine breaking that.
Or you could just put it on top.
I could, but it would be ugly up there, Ferg. You know that.
Because the solar power on top isn't?
What's your point?
You right. People in your machine. Fine. It doesn't look like a machine as a box.
I'll put it up there, but I'll come back later when you're not here, and I'm going to move it.
What else is new? I like how we just signified that this is where the generator is going, right in this corner.
It just worked out that way.
It's kind of a centralized location. I mean, we've got our crafting on one side, we've got our farms for the fuel on the other side.
Yeah, it makes sense, I think. Yeah. Would you mind if I took the atomic reconstructor and moved it down to the crafting stuff downstairs?
I don't mind.
You can go. I don't mind.
All right.
I like this little safety platform down here by the rest of your machines. There's tons of room down here. We could have put the generator down here.
Well, we could have, but that wasn't there when Preacher built the generator. It's there now. I think ultimately I'd like to move the auto sieve, the Vaygrim in a box over there, down to right next to those machines. That's the triplicator system there.
Yeah.
Come back with my machine. I want to use it.
Mulrett says he doesn't like the Unity looks. I like Cyanide X's work. But yeah, although, you know, mechanism really needed an overhaul. You know, being an older mod, and yeah, there were machine textures from many different generations there, and it just didn't. You put all your machines together and it looked like a patchwork. So, hey, welcome back, Itachi. So now at least they all have the same sort of look and feel to them. But yeah, I don't think. I mean, I like Cyanide X's work, so I'm not going to diss Cyanide X, but. Yeah, I don't think it's better, but it's not a huge upgrade as far as visually speaking, anyway. Just my opinion, for what it's worth.
Don't like how they look. There's this thing called a texture pack. Ah!
Yeah, well, that's true, right? Yeah.
Where'd you go with my machine I need?
What's that? What are you looking for? Somebody
the thing you're running around with in your hand.
Oh. Were you looking for the reconstructor?
Yes.
I've got it.
I know.
Did I do it backwards?
I don't know what it is.
You might want to turn it sideways.
Nope. There we go. I just thought I'd shoot it toward the base of the ladder here.
Ferg, come to the ladder.
Which ladder?
Yeah, we'd like you to check this out over here.
Far back one.
I just make sure we did this right.
Why are we asking me? It's not like I know.
Oh, you said you were looking for it, right? It didn't seem
that's the right spot, right?
It didn't seem to do anything to him, unfortunately.
Do I feel violated or something?
You should.
Making stuff.
Oh, hey.
Good luck, you thief.
It's not me, it's the coin. I swear.
Quit taking my crap!
I've given up my thieving ways. It's the coin. I blame the coin. You don't happen to have any energy conduit on you, do you?
Nope.
Could use a couple pieces of that right about now. This is what I'm hoping to get away from sometime soon here, is to get everything kind of centralized so we don't have to keep running back and forth for stuff.
Although we seem to run around more and more for stuff.
I know, I'm trying to minimize that as much as possible. There we go. All powered up, good to go. But we don't really need power to the solder, do we? But whatever.
Yeah, it connects to the system.
It's there. It's there.
The system gets power, it gets power.
Yeah. Well, we could park it here right next to the disk drive, between the disk drive and the crafter.
Can you at least wait until I get done with all this stuff?
Obviously not.
No, you go. That's okay. Like I was telling Ferg, I'll just wait till you're gone.
I feel that's some sort of threat or something.
Not at all. All right, so we've got some extra storage in the capacitor.
I like how I just stole the remote control for the all the storage. I've been running around with that for 5 minutes.
Yeah, I was gonna make 3 of them, one for each of us, but it took so long making that first one. I thought I'll just put it here and we can share it. It's got a lot of little pieces in it, and it was late, and all the pieces kind of look the same. It's like, oh, it's the one with the blue dot. Oh, it's the one with the yellow dot.
Darn you, dots.
Yeah. Well, I don't know how that looks to, if you've got color blindness issues. I'm not sure how easy it is to use the, craft the refined storage stuff. Because a lot of that, it all looks exactly the same. It's just the top of the dot is blue on one and yellow on another and red on the other. All right, so how are we doing on production here? Do you have everything swapped out for fertilized dirt now, Ferg?
Yep, everything's all fertilized dirt.
Okay, well, do you want me to start making some like greenhouse glass, or were you doing that, or what?
I was actually working on the tree farm that we so desperately need.
Okay, so which style tree farm are you going for?
I went with the actually additions one because it was cheap.
Oh, okay. Do you have that machine out here yet? I haven't seen that.
No, I'm just putting it together.
Okay. Well, don't let me rush you.
Stop rushing me!
Wait, actually additions is a tree farm?
Well, it's the farmer. It should cut trees, doesn't it?
It doesn't do trees.
Oh, yeah, sorry, no. Yeah.
Well, darn, now we got an extra one.
Hey, extra farmer helps.
Yeah, actually, we could use that extra farmer.
You could be old McFerg had a farm.
Yeah, I see how well this goes.
Hey, you can be the farm guy.
Been there, done that. No, thank you.
I'll be the tech guy, and Greylock can be the OCD guy who goes around behind us both and cleans up after us.
I'm not OCD. I just like a tidy base. That's all. There's nothing OCD about it.
Like I said.
Greylock, have you seen my base?
Yeah.
You have your work cut out for you,
sir. Yeah, I have seen your base. Actually, you know, you show a whole lot of creativity in your bases, Ferg. I know that you are self-deprecating, but you make some pretty good builds.
I didn't say anything that. I was just talking about my organizational skills.
Yeah, well, okay.
Throw it all on a chest. Let everything else sort itself out.
Soaring chests everywhere.
I usually try and contain them to like one few small areas.
Yeah, and I do the same thing until I just start to get frustrated because I can't find anything more. And you know, where you get to the point where you open and close five chests until you finally find what you want, and you get tired of hearing the little creaky chest noise, and it's already late at night, and you're already halfway cranky anyway. And then the next thing I'll do is build a storage system after that.
I just get tired of the comments, organize your chests!
Yeah. We got birch wood here.
Let's see. Did we ever make the monster thing for Ender.io?
A monster thing? What kind of monster thing? Talking about the, what is it, the slice and dice? The slice and
yeah,
splice?
Yeah, the slice and dice.
Yeah?
The thing with slice the floating zombie. The thing with the floating zombie head in it that glares at you.
Yeah, that's the one. Slice and splice, I think. Splice and slice, yeah. Those are pretty handy. What was I doing? I was going to make some more platforms.
Well, you can you can make an enderite slice and splice decoration block.
Yeah, what's the deal with all the decoration blocks? What does that mean?
I don't know.
I saw those and I thought, what is a decoration box block? And I didn't ever really get back to it. I got distracted by something else.
I have no idea. Oh,
right.
Good.
I thought
we have soul sand.
Oh, yeah, we've got soul sand.
Yeah, we should have plenty of soul sand, actually.
Yep. Oh, we got plenty of gold, too.
Yep.
Perfect.
We should have no shortage when it comes to ores. We've got hundreds of ingots because our little Vaygrim worker here has been working steadily for us. But
everyone should have a Vaygrim slave.
I know. Don't tell him he's in a glass box. He thinks he's Minecrafting. Go, Vaygrim. You're doing a great job. That's an awesome build there, Vaygrim. Just keep going.
Oh, good. Wait, this is so
props. Well, there's talk about those decorator blocks. Yeah, I'm not sure what those are because it's like you'll which decorator block were you just looking at, Ferg?
The one for the slice and splice. Just quietly wait my turn.
So if I look at the slice and splice, so here it is. So here's the decoration block. And then here's like the real one, I guess. So the decoration block, it says it comes in several different colors. Charcoal gray, black, or dark brown. So what's the recipe for that? Oh, so the recipe for that is that. And the recipe for the real one is that. Yeah, I don't get it. I don't know. I don't understand what the difference is between the two.
Maybe it's like a painter block for it.
Huh. Yeah, I don't know. Mallrat says it's safe to decorate with. There's no tile entity, so it doesn't actually do anything. It's just a prop. It's
a troll block.
The troll block. Yeah, you could set up this base for someone, and it's all decorator blocks.
Or go into somebody's base and swap it all out.
Well, I of course understand what decorate means, Vaygrim, but I've never actually used one of those. I was just kind of curious about how that actually works. Who's giving me apples?
I'm trying to get myself food.
here, just take them. Just take them, quick. Take them. It's like I'm juggling. All right, fine.
I wanted with some apples.
There you go. Make apple juice, by the way. It's much more efficient.
That's what I was going to do.
Yeah, so
you... I run around with the wireless grid some more.
Yeah, that's right. Well, I'm glad it's working out for you. Because none of us needed it.
Good. And all the stuff is missing out of it. Preacher!
Give me a minute.
Oh, are you working on the storage system over there, Breach?
Yeah, I'm cleaning it up a little bit. I made a larger disk.
Yeah.
And I'm cleaning off the smaller disks.
Oh, cool.
So, just give it a bit.
Alright, good sir. If I starve to death, it's on you.
Yeah, you should be able to find something in there. Look, there's 12 potatoes right there.
You know, it's always creepy when you're, like, working, you're doing your thing, and then you glance over to the left at the farm animals, and they're, like, all staring at you. Like, there's this chicken peeking over the fence at me right now. And it's almost like they're thinking something, and you wonder how long they've been watching you and what it is that they're planning over there.
Yeah, they're plotting our demise.
It's kind of creepy. Kind of creepy. Alright. Those all match. Okay, so we got extra storage here. I was going to make greenhouse blocks, wasn't I? That I need, if I remember right, a bunch of lapis, and I should just look at the recipe for that. I just did it last night, but greenhouse. So what do we need? We need one of them, a bunch of saplings, and a bunch of glass. And that is just an energized lapis block. I need some saplings, though. That's what I'm going to need. Do we have a bunch of saplings around? I know we've been just kind of using them as we needed them. I don't think we've made any effort to stockpile any. There's some.
Hi.
Alright. I may have to do some manual labor here. I'm hoping to avoid it.
Well, I'm trying.
I don't know what you're talking about, Ferg. The refined storage system works just fine.
As I'm still holding the controller in my inventory.
It's handy, isn't it? I like the little thing.
I have a feeling I'm going to log out with this thing if I keep forgetting to put it back.
Are you crafting stuff, Preacher?
No, I'm moving things.
Oh,
I got the disc
manipulator
over here.
All right, so we need that. We need some glass. It has no glass.
That's because it's all in the discs that are in the disc manipulator and everything's getting moved over.
Oh, you know, fine time for IT to come in here and start moving around hardware.
I know, right? That's what I've been saying.
Hey, system enhancements will continue, all right?
Shall I open up another
service
ticket? By the way, there's still no glass.
You get paid by the hour.
Alright, what am I going to do? Oh no, I'm going to cut some trees is what I'm going to do. I'm going to need saplings, and Ferg isn't producing any for me yet. You guys are all letting me down. Preacher, you take my hard drives down. Ferg takes off with my remote storage device.
I put it back.
Oh, we don't have our fast leaf decay anymore, do we? Forgot about that. I don't cut too many trees. What do we have to cut down leaves really quick? Do we have like a scythe or something? Or
The dark steel shears.
Yeah? Okay, so now back to those the cosmetic recipes. I'm just talking here while I cut down trees. Mallrat and Vaygrim, it sounds like you guys have worked with the cosmetics. It looked like those recipes were almost identical to the actual device's recipe, but it doesn't actually work though. But still, it almost costs you almost the same as what it seemed like, or pretty close to the same, just for a box that doesn't actually do anything. I would think that if it were truly just cosmetic, that it would be fairly cheap, you know, like Raz's Decocraft stuff, where it's just like clay.
Oh crud,
what'd you do?
I used my one zombie head in the slot. Oh, there's creepers, there's skeletons. I need that zombie head. I used it in the slice and splice. Why?
We got no more heads? Yeah, actually, you know what? We haven't found too many zombie heads.
You know, it might be time to upgrade the spikes again.
The diamonds?
Yep.
Just so that we can get those drops?
Yep.
Wow. It seems like it's taking a really long time for these leaves to decay. Now, maybe I've just been spoiled by the fast decay, but, I mean, this is taking a really long time.
Welcome to vanilla.
What's funny is we have so many skeleton heads, but we have no zombie heads.
Yeah, I'm not sure how that worked out. I guess because they have no flesh, their heads just fall off easier.
Did either one of you notice those messages that kept popping up in chat?
What messages? Nope. No.
System status update transmitting.
Oh, system status update transmitting. Oh, that could be bad. Audio channels open. System update message to follow shortly. I didn't notice that. That looks like something I should have noticed, though. Okay.
Yeah.
System status update transmitting. All right. Well, we have to wait and see what the update is, I guess. Fast leaf decay for life. Yeah. Fast leaf decay for the win. This is like really slow. This is like the slow leaf decay mod is what this is.
Yeah, pretty much.
Do you have any bone meal left, Ferg, from making the fertilized dirt?
Should be in the system.
Oh. Okay.
I had a bunch left. Good luck fighting IT. If not, you can get bones. There's like 500 and some fill.
Well, if I've got any problem with the system, I'll just open up a trouble ticket to IT. Of course, the trouble ticket system may be down. But... Okay. Meal. There it is. Lots of
Sorry, you're taking my union break.
That doesn't surprise me.
And then I have to take my union regulated break from taking my union break.
So your union broken. Got it.
Pretty much.
That's some bad union.
So, Preacher, you were saying it was 64 degrees when you went on your little walk this afternoon?
Oh, yeah, but it was windy as heck.
Wow. I don't think it got above 60 today in Southern California.
I barely got above 20. You guys can just be quiet.
Yeah, I've been watching some of the weather reports from your part of the country. No thank you.
Ferg lives at the bottom of a deep freeze.
Literally. I usually live in the warmer area. Thank goodness for heat island effect.
Yeah, well, I'm in Illinois in January, and it was 64 degrees.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy.
That's not supposed to happen. That's not normal.
Yeah.
I have an egg in my inventory. I'm going to need those. I'm going to keep this because I made more trees. I'm going to put that remote back because I'm good at sharing.
Well, kudos to you.
I always got the gold star in kindergarten because I was good at sharing.
I'm the oldest sibling. Sharing is not in my nature.
Not in the vocabulary.
Share? Didn't she sing with Sunny?
Yeah, wasn't she the scary Adam's Family looking lady?
Yeah.
Chicago weather. Now that's actually not a good thing. Tanchi says sometimes he gets Chicago weather because, I mean, Chicago, that's the windy city, so they get the cold wind out of the north and off of the Great Lakes, right?
Yep.
Alright, what is that? Somebody sharpening
that's
a pencil?
Door.
Like an old pencil sharpener.
It does, doesn't it?
So getting Chicago weather is not necessarily a good thing then, Itanchi, I would think. It does, at least to my Southern Californian self, it doesn't sound like a good thing.
It's not.
Yeah, it's definitely not.
Grow, darn you, grow! Don't make me twerk over you, I will do it.
Sounds like a questionable threat. Poor life choices!
For the win in this case, because it actually works.
Your story, you tell it how you want to.
There we go. Stack upgrade, free speed upgrades. The disk manipulator is working quicker.
Alright.
I'm just throwing my random stuff in there.
Random stoof.
Because I like to know. I like causing chaos. It happens naturally.
Well, that's the thing, is that you don't even really seem to cause it. It just sort of seems to follow you. It's kind of like, Pigpen from, you know, the Peanuts, you know? He always has this, you know, dust cloud around, and that's chaos for you.
Yeah, just pretty much. Of, just Murphy's sort of Law.
Follows you.
Murphy's Law, yay!
Alright, I've got a few saplings now, so I can go make some greenhouse glass.
Yay!
Yay for greenhouse glass. That, and I'm just plain tired of chopping trees.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, I got a chicken this time. Couldn't tell you how many eggs I've thrown in this world and not got a single chicken. Oh, he's a cute one, too. This is actually an especially cute chicken. It's not like the normal Minecraft chickens. This one is especially cute. I'm going to call him Buster. That's Buster the chicken.
Ah, speed upgrades.
What are you speed upgrading over there?
The solderer.
Oh, the solderer. Do we? Yes. We don't have too many pieces that we're still soldering, do we? I mean, aren't we pretty much done making the refined storage stuff? No.
I'm adding more storage.
Ah, gotcha. Tender the chicken. This is my chicken teriyaki. All right. Meanwhile, back to the greenhouse class. So I've got. Let's take a look at this recipe again here. Green. Only two out keys. Greenhouse glass. I keep wanting
here
to say
go.
Greenhouse glass.
Yay!
So I need to make some of those, and we need to get some glass. So we have our storage all updated.
Oh yeah, now we can hold 32,000 items.
Now is that a quantity of 32,000 or 32,000 types of items?
32,000 items.
Items, total.
Total.
Alright.
That's a lot of items.
It seems like it.
It's going to be a little bit before we run into an issue.
Okay, we don't have much glass. We'll have to make some glass. I actually don't even have much sand either. We've been turning so much of that sand into dust to make our resources. We don't actually have much, just sand.
Holy moly, we got bone blocks. Yeah, I think we got plenty of bones.
Yeah, shouldn't have a problem with bones.
And now I'm going to go fetch a cyber eye.
Oh, did you make the box of surgery?
Not yet. I'm going to make the scanner first.
Ah. Yeah, we got like a ton of them cyber eyes.
So what happens when you install those?
You get different things that you can use.
You can install like it by itself with no power, you're blind.
Or if you take your eyes out, you're blind.
Yeah, right, okay.
If you accidentally take your arms out. Yeah.
That's funny.
Yeah, you take your arms off and you can't use tools, you can't do nothing.
How funny.
Although we have three sets of Wolverine claws, which is funny.
So I assume that you can get the usual kinds of upgrades, like night vision and I don't know what else. Like, can you like zoom in? If you like telephoto vision?
Yep.
Dun 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 dun. Yeah, I don't think we have the diamonds to quite upgrade to the next tier of those yet. Because it's going to take a lot.
Did I get it wrong? Palace. Oh, I still need to like energize it is what I need to do. Oh, I did it wrong. That's what I did. No, maybe I didn't do it. No, I did. I did.
Paper.
Okay. So now I need to energize it.
Bert?
What?
Please tell me that's not a creeper in our farm.
No, that's Ferg.
There is a creeper in our farm. What a quinky dink.
Hello, creeper.
He wants to be my friend.
What's he doing?
Sitting in our farm. I'm baiting him for preacher.
Got him.
Helping.
Where is it not lit over here?
That's a good question.
I'm not seeing a not lit place. Huh. I wonder where he came from. Maybe he just grew here.
Here?
He is a shrubbery.
No, like right here where I'm standing.
I don't see a little yellow or red X over there.
I see plenty of yellow X's.
Oh, for it.
Like right here.
Oh, I see. Actually, underneath the. Well, now.
Under the canola. That's weird.
That is weird. I saw the yellow X's and I just ignored that. Because I didn't think that they would spawn there.
I have got us new upgraded spikes for the farm.
Well, that helped a little bit.
Huh.
So we can get zombie heads so we can actually build a farm.
Hmm.
Well, we could, you know, we do have the floodlight mod. We can put a floodlight at one end of it and just flood the whole place.
That would work.
Yeah.
I'll go work on that.
Oh, alright, cool. That'd be neat.
I was
going
to get some paper. Take it out to the scanner over by the mob farm.
Yeah.
Oh!
Alright, for right now, though, just so we don't get any more surprises, I'm going to clear one of these squares and light it up. Alright, now we're all covered.
Mistakes were made!
The kind of mistakes you can recover from, or is this going to be like a regret for your whole life kind of thing? Still not sure. Alright, prismarine. That can come from nether quartz. So I'm going to need...
I may have failed in my design.
Uh-oh.
I have no way to turn it off.
Famous last words. Oh, by the way, there's no way to turn it off. We don't really have any nether quartz, do we? Oh. Start from scratch here.
Yeah, we've got 3 blocks of quartz over here. Could go put it through the crusher.
Alright.
Alright, that's a good option. I like that option. Sure beats sifting a bunch of soul sand.
There we go!
And if I put it through the sag mill, will I get it out? Let's try one through here and see what happens.
Farm has been upgraded. We're getting zombie heads soon.
Yeah, Mallrat, I was thinking the same thing. I saw the yellow X's underneath the canola, but I didn't think it would be a big deal since it was tilled dirt. But obviously it is. At least we're assuming that's where the creeper came from.
Now, should I go with the non-electric, the electric, or the UV floodlight?
I don't know the difference.
Wait.
Yeah, let's try the non-electric.
Missed.
Wouldn't we want the UV one, because it's going to be going over the farm?
What's the UV one?
I don't know.
You're just making stuff up.
Just sounded like something.
It sounds very high-tech.
Well, it's ultraviolet light. So
I know what UV stands
that?
For. I didn't think it was like, you know, ultra-violent.
No, that's me.
Unvile. Like, you're really nice. You're unvile. Mall rat. Oh, help! Yeah, it's a good thing I was paying attention. Because I was just in my inventory. It's like I could have just silently just drowned there. Mall rat, who seems to know a little bit about everything, says you don't want the UV one, it'll damage entities.
I'm an entity, and I'm very much opposed to that.
I'm an entity as well. I guess my doctor warned me about exposure to ultraviolet light. okay, so I was working on this. I need to take that. And I need to make that special empowered blocky thingy. What is that? That is... Okay, so I've got enough prismarine shards. I need to get a couple more cyan dye, which is lapis and cactus. There's a couple of cacti. Now, do I have a lapi? Should've. It flew out of me here. Oh. One of those. Oh, I need to make a cactus green, not just cactus.
Go use the sheep.
What are you talking about?
Change the color of the sheep.
I need the dye.
Yeah, grind the dye, get the dye. Grind the wool, get the dye.
Well, I've got cactus in the cooker already. But
won't be that way.
Hey, you're trying to tell me something funky to do the sheep. I'm just going to sit down here quietly and cook my cactus.
I'm just going to stare intensely.
That was a little startling. Okay. So I need to do this. So we got to put one of these on there. And then, oh, where's my shards? And
well, gents, it's getting that time for me.
What? You just got here.
An hour ago.
In an hour.
Feels like longer.
That's not right. I put the lapis on there.
Don't make me knock you off the edge.
Crystals, that's right over there. There it goes. Stand back, said the elephant. I'm going to sneeze.
Hey, I did something.
Yeah,
I
you
made
did.
Us a slice and spice.
Yeah.
And then I upgraded our mob farm so we can get heads so we can make a farm.
Hey, Greylock?
Yes, sir?
You got any energy conduit?
No, I dropped two or three of them in the refined storage system, though.
Ah, okay.
But that's all we have is what's in there right now. Well, good night, Ferg.
Night.
Oops. Place that block. Wink. All right, how do I get that out of there? Do I need an open hand? Do I need? There we go. I needed an open hand. All right, gotta put one of these here. There. And that's already powered, so I'll replace it with that. All the particles. Right now I have all the particles from this entire server out here right now. That's it, I'm sucking them all up, every single one of the particles.
You do that.
There we go. It seems like it takes a long time sometimes to empower these things. Alright, got another one of those. Oh, I guess they don't stack. Oh, no, they do stack. Okay. And then I'll do a third. I think I just want to do... I've got enough to do more. I might as well just do more. I should really use it if I make it. So the actual...
Really need some...
What's that?
Really need some flight.
Oh, you're feeling the pinch of not being able to fly around?
A little bit.
So that floodlight, is it very resource intensive?
Not really.
All right, last one. Boop. Well, there's the overworld base over there.
Here we go.
Did you get it all lit up?
Oh,
cool. I'm going to run up there and check that out. Sounds pretty exciting. Out there in the chat room, how is the music levels, by the way? Oh, this is an electric floodlight.
Yep.
Cool. Is it on?
Yep.
What does it look like when it's off? Oh, got a little lag there when I turned it off. Okay, so that's what it looks like when it's off. Oh, a little lag when I turned it on, too.
I think we can get rid of all the torches over here.
Probably, I would think so. But of course, if the power goes out, then all of a sudden this becomes a monster spawner.
Oh, yeah, well. I mean, it's got a buffer of 50,000 RF in it.
Yeah. Maybe we just put a little door.
And besides, it's lighting up our farm.
Yeah. That is pretty cool. All right. I want to see what it looks like at night. All right. Thanks, Critter C. How you been, by the way? You've been really quiet in the chat room. I actually kind of like this song. This song is actually on my workout playlist as well. This is a very inspiring piece of music when you're near the end of your workout and you're feeling exhausted, but you just have to carry on.
See, I had something similar to that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was called a drone instructor.
Inspiring, right?
Inspiring, in quotes.
Mm-hmm. Did you have one of those... I just got a... this is Chrome. I just got an error message from Chrome here. I had Beam playing in the background. I just got an error message from Chrome saying it ran out of memories. I'll have to reset that. So, did you actually have, the stereotypical drill instructor experience?
That and then some.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Instead of being in boot camp for 3 months, I was in boot camp for 4 months.
Wow, why is that?
When I first got there, I wasn't strong enough to actually pass the initial fitness exam.
Oh, gotcha.
I got in on a fluke.
On a fluke? You just barely made it to medical?
Yeah, basically. I pulled off 2 pull-ups, and I don't know how.
I don't remember how it happened.
Well, I remember how it happened, just I don't know how I did it.
Yeah.
And then 2 days later, there I am trying to do it in front of drone instructors, and I can't even get one.
Oh, no.
So I spent an entire month
mm-hmm.
building up my strength right. So that way I could pass the physical fitness test. Passed it, and then 3 days after that was September 11th.
Oh, yeah, right, okay.
Yeah, not a fun time.
And you thought, oh no, what am I in for now?
My drill instructors told me, you're going to war as soon as you get done with boot camp and school.
Right.
They weren't far off.
Yeah. So where did you do your tour?
Let's see. I was in San Diego for boot camp, and then I went to 29 Palms for comm school. Mm-hmm. And then I got shipped out to North Carolina to be stationed at Camp Lejeune with 8th Comm. And then...
So you're down at Pendleton then. You did boot camp at Pendleton? Is that right?
I did part of boot camp at Pendleton. The other part was in San Diego, right next to the airport.
Gotcha. Yeah, because I have family friends that went through boot camp down there. Of course, I mean, being in this area, you know, if anybody joins the Marines, that tends to be where they go through, is Pendleton.
Yeah, we had one guy who was local. His dad was a lieutenant colonel.
Mm-hmm.
And a Marine.
Oh.
So, dad was an officer in the Marines.
Yeah.
And Junior decided he wanted to go and be a Marine, too.
Oh.
Drill instructors had a field day with him.
I'm sure. Wow, it seems like you put a lot of work into making just half a dozen blocks of glass. Trying to find a little pattern here I can make. So I don't feel like my effort was completely wasted. Yeah, so that that family friend who signed up for the Marines, he was kind of in a similar sort of situation in that, I don't even think they would let him actually sign up. He had to do some physical work first before they'd let him sign up. But he wanted to do it, and so he stuck with it, and he was doing his pull-ups every day, and because he was a pretty, you know, sedentary kind of kid, playing a lot of video games mostly.
Yeah, sounds like me.
But he wanted to do it, so he did, and it turned his life around, really. It really did. It was a really good experience for him overall. It was a character builder.
Yeah, it helped my confidence, but and in the end, it broke my brain.
Oh, really? Well, they do break you down, and they're supposed to build you back up again.
Well, no, the entire Marine Corps experience for me kind of broke my brain.
Oh, with the whole PTSD kind of thing, yeah?
Yeah. Not fun.
Yeah, I can't imagine, and honestly don't care to. Yep.
Don't blame me there.
I appreciate the service that those men in uniform perform for us. That's for sure.
Now, I wonder. Oh, hey, it does work.
What's that? What works? Oh, hey, it's nighttime. Let's go check on the light. I'm sorry, what's that?
The signal for the gravel ores.
I'm going to check out this floodlight. Well, is it flooding? All right, well. Oh, there we go. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's a big difference, all right. Nice.
That lit up the entire platform over there.
Yeah. I wonder, does it pull much RF, I wonder?
I don't think so.
It says power 15. What does that mean? That's redstone.
RF storage.
That's redstone.
RF storage of 50K 50, 000, out of 50K.
Yeah. But I wonder how much it's actually pulling, keeping that lit. I'm just wondering if we want to put a light sensor on it or something like that, maybe.
Yeah, that wouldn't work. That would probably work.
Right, that way.
Daylight
we're not,
sensor.
Yeah, so we're not pulling power when it's already, you know, daylight. We don't need it, kind of thing.
Yep. Let me see if I'm making one of those.
Yeah, that works out pretty cool. I'm liking that. So, Greater C, you were in the Air Force.
Oh, a zoomie.
What did you do in the Air Force?
Eat better chow than the rest of the military?
Yeah, other than that. I've heard the Navy eats pretty well, actually.
Not really.
That's what I've heard. That's what they told me when they wanted me to sign up for a Navy scholarship. Was it bunk? Is that not true?
They have slightly better chow than the Marines, but slightly worse chow than the Army.
Yeah. If I would have joined in and picked up that scholarship, I probably would have been in the nuclear engineering program. Probably in a submarine.
Oh, so many jokes, but they're not family friendly.
Oh, so I'm sorry, I didn't read that correctly, Greater C. So you weren't able to join the Air Force. Would have been computer programming. Yeah. So were you doing that? You were doing that when you were trying to sign up. You were already in the computer engineering or computer software kind of business.
Yeah, that's what I was going in the Marine Corps for. I ended up with radio communications.
Yeah? How was that?
It sucked.
Oh, really? Why is that?
But I spent a good portion of my time soldering 50-pin power connectors, so my soldering skills are really good.
Yeah. You can get a nice, tight solder joint.
Oh, yeah. That, and I can make a radio transmitter antenna that can enable you to have a conversation with yourself just from the delay.
That's useful. Gotcha. Creator C was saying in the chat that he was actually able to join, but he got injured during boot camp.
And got out with a medical. Lucky.
Is that the way it works? If you get if you get in, but then you get dropped during boot camp, do you still end up with the benefits and everything as if you had served?
Sometimes. It depends on how long you were in boot camp.
Okay, so I need to be juicing up that lapis.
I'm feeding Vaygrim a steady diet of potato to make sure he makes a lot of quartz.
Yeah, keep that guy working. Don't let him slack off.
Now let's just hope that the buildup of mesh over on the other end of the system works.
I did have to reseat that Ender.io interface over there when I logged in this evening. It was it looked like it was connected and everything, but it wasn't actually doing anything. So we still got some latent Ender.io issues right now.
Well, the iron mesh is about to break in this, so we'll find out.
It should, but okay, yeah. We'll find out.
Yep, it works.
Nice. That was exactly what the problem was, is that they wasn't, you know, it wasn't pulling meshes and they were broken. That's how I found it, because I was wondering why Vaygrim was slacking off on us there. And
need a hopper.
None in refined storage right now.
Yeah, I checked using the wireless terminal.
There is a chest, though, if you want to grab that and add some iron to it. Alright, I'm a cyan. I need nether quartz is what I need. I don't know how long we'd be able to avoid sifting for nether quartz. Oh, we got some more blocks. Cool. Be able to duck it for a little while longer.
I added a hopper on top of Vaygrim's box.
For
manual.
Oh, okay. Does that get priority over what gets piped in?
Yes, it does.
Oh, cool. That's nice. So now you've got the sag mill grinding up copper ore gravel.
Yep. And it works just like regular ore processing.
Were we getting low on copper? Should have a lot of copper.
No, I was just seeing if it worked.
Oh, gotcha. Okay. Yeah, because we've got like almost 600 ingots of copper. We don't really use copper for that much. I'm just going to interrupt here for a little bit so I can run some quartz. Oh, wait, that was aesthetic quartz. Aesthetic, not aesthetic, but aesthetic quartz.
Check the system again. I just tossed some quartz blocks in there.
That's a real word, aesthetic.
I blame Alpec. He's the one that came up with the word.
Oh, really? Aesthetic? Like I said, I've heard of aesthetic before.
Nah, he decided to come up with a whole bunch of made-up words for his crystals, except for void.
All right. Well, I assume, I mean, a lot of these are just, you know, he's basically just sort of revised the original word. Like, for example, if you take a lapis block and energize it, you get palace. Right?
Or restonia for redstone.
Right, exactly, yeah. All right, so we got the nether quartz, and so I'm going to turn it into the prismarine stuff. Boink! Oh, didn't get all of it. Boink. Alright, so I've got enough for four more blocks. Well, it just seems like it takes so many steps producing this stuff. Is that everything I need? I got the palace, and I got prismarine, and I got cyan dye. That should be everything I need. Start laying it out here. Prismarine. Prismarine. Palace crystal. There it goes. Release the particules! And with all these particles going, it is like a particule down here. Watch my FPS's drop. Here we are at 46. Oh, it was back up to 70. Alright. Grab that. Grab the next one. These display stands for actually additions, they kind of look like they're camo. Bloop. Alright. It'll be nice to be able to get our canola production bumped up. Cause we've got enough power for when we need it. I think we're getting 600 RF per tick out of it or something like that. So for right now we're covered there, but we don't have enough canola oil being produced fast enough for when we are actually burning that at 600 RF. Oh, I don't want to do that. Oh, I especially didn't want to do that. So, Preacher, do you have any, like, big picture vision for what you want to do here with the sky base? Because we're at the point now where, I mean, we're getting all the resources we need, and it's really kind of down to which conveniences we want to build for ourselves at this point.
Well, we still need to build a tree farm. I kind of want to go with McJetty's design from his single-player series.
Okay, yeah.
Using the RF Tools Builder.
Mm-hmm.
And eventually I want to get us all cyberwared up.
Mallrat warns, this is how the Cybermen started. Alright, some more greenhouse glass. Oh, actually, no, I haven't made it yet. Oh, gosh. You know, I went through so many different steps. I thought, oh, okay, I'm finally done, but no, I'm not done. So, a couple more steps to go through. I need, okay, I think I've got everything I need on me, though. Greenhouse. Saplings, glass. Oh, I'm missing the glass. I guess I must have to pull the glass out. No, I did, but I put it back. Do you have the remote with you? Are you using it? I can just go downstairs, I guess.
I got the remote. You want it?
No, that's okay. I was going downstairs. That's cool. No, too late. I'm going down. I'm almost
there. I already put it up, so.
So that's fine. We shall need 16. Okay, still fine. Okay, finally. Alright, we'll get that. Pull those. Alright, another dozen. Still only a small fraction of the 81 that we're going to need to cover the area with greenhouse glass. If it wasn't for the empowering process, we could automate this.
Actually, we can automate the empowering process.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, we just need more crafters. Or at the very least, one crafter and some ender IO conduit and some filters.
I'm just thinking, by the time we do all that, chances are I could be done making this greenhouse glass anyway.
Probably.
Do we start having any stockpiled up yet? Yeah, I got a little canola stockpiled up.
Oh, it's raining.
And then it rained. So we got full tanks here, 14,000 millibuckets. Got a full stack.
Yeah, now Greylock, yeah. I know I know California's had a drought this year, and it's been a while since you've seen it, but this is rain.
Hey, you know what? Actually, it's been raining here recently, and it's been really creepy. It's like been cold and wet, and after a couple days of it, I'm done. So we got ourselves a real legit auto hammer now. None of this mechanical user stuff.
Yep.
Well, you know
you
what?
Can move that wherever you want it, so.
Oh. That's fine there for right now.
Right now I've got it just working manually.
You know, for the auto sieve, they did a really cool job of putting this little guy inside there, but how come there's no little guy for the auto hammer?
I don't know.
It's just a couple of ghostly hammers. Just sort of float, three ghostly hammers floating away in there.
Yeah, that's kind of what it is.
Huh. All right. Well, I guess he spent so much time doing the auto sieve, he was tired when it came time to do the auto hammer. Now, I did set up some sort of automation on the canola farmer so that once we get a stockpile of canola, we can set it on an auto mode, and so the farmer will only work when the advanced generator is actually turned on.
Well, that's good.
Yeah, so because otherwise we're just, you know, the farmer is using power, basically just, you know, stockpiling more canola, but and so it's just a little more efficient that way, I think. But I want to at least get us our stockpile back again first. And we'll flip it over to auto. And I did actually, I don't know if you saw the sign on the other side of the planter. The farmer, rather. There's a little sign that shows you which is on and which is auto. Right, so if it's down, then the farmer stays on. If you flip it up, then it only turns on when the advanced generator is running. So, Preacher, you've got Life in the Buffer running right now as one of your Let's Plays. What else have you got going as far as Let's Plays?
Right now I've got just Life in the Buffer and Quest for Sanctuary. And right now, I'm working on the pack for Season 3 of Quest for Sanctuary.
Oh, really? All right. So what's the kind of the focus of the Quest for Sanctuary pack?
Basically, it's just I make a pack with some mods in it and then just show different ways of using them.
All right, cool. So the focus is Preacher likes it.
Yep.
Good enough.
Well, that and I released the pack for Season 2. Like the other day.
Oh, okay.
I spent all of Season 2 basically tweaking the pack and making sure it worked.
Gotcha.
Which meant going through quite a few crashes every now and then.
So was that a part of your Let's Play then? I haven't really watched any of the Quest for Sanctuary episodes. Is that like part of it where you're actually testing out the mods?
Yeah, basically.
Oh, cool.
It was, all right, this works like this. This works together with this. That's the reason why I noticed that the advanced generator works really well with the oil from actually additions.
Yeah, sure.
Now, for some reason, in this pack, the higher tiers of oil aren't working with the advanced generator, but I don't know why.
Huh. Yeah, I saw that mentioned in the VC4 Discord channel, and I'm not sure if there's a workaround that, if it's a configuration thing or what. But that would be nice if the higher tier canola oils would actually be a you know, higher valued fuel too. For sure. Alright, let's go see if I can get some more nether quartz to turn into prismarine shards. Oh, there's actual real nether quartz here. And there's some blocks. So I'm going to need another 12. Palace crystal. That's going to be energized. And I'll need 12. 16 blocks of glass. I'm good there. Alright. Alright, there's my prismarine. There's my cyan. There's my palace crystal. Now you can only do one at a time on the empowerer, right? Like I could stack up three here.
No. That works.
Yeah. Yeah, I actually don't usually notice too much whether it's night or day, but when Vagram's on, he's always flipping that. I usually don't even realize it until, you know, I see the wakey wakey message and all of a sudden everything gets bright around me. It's like, oh yeah, it was nighttime, I guess.
Yeah.
I just get focused, I guess.
That reminds me, I need to go and check the scanner over here. I set it up to do a blueprint for Cyber Eyes.
I haven't seen any of that stuff. Where is all that, by the way? I'll go check some of that stuff out.
Oh, yes, we got a Cyber Eyes blueprint.
So now, what does it take to make the blueprints?
Just paper in the scanner with the thing you're trying to make a blueprint for.
Oh, you take one of what you want and you drop it in the scanner with paper and now you've got a blueprint for it?
Yeah, but it takes a long while for it to actually get a blueprint.
All right. So is that usually where you start off in the wired mod, is with the eyes, cyber eyes?
Cyberware, actually, and yeah.
So Mallrat says it takes about 20 minutes, and the more items you scan at a time, the better chance to get the blueprint. So does that mean that there's a chance you won't get a blueprint after your 20 minutes of scanning?
Yeah.
Is that true? Huh. Alright.
Alright, got Cyber Eye scanned, and now I'm going to scan the HUD jack.
16. I need more trees is what I need. There's these saplings in storage here. Oh! Perfect! Actually, I need 16. Alright, not quite so perfect. But better. So what are some of the cooler augments that you can get with that system?
Well, let's see here. Let's see, there's bone lacing.
Does that make you tougher? Take more damage?
Increased health.
Increased health, alright.
Synthetic skin, which hides your cyber limbs. There's subdermal spikes, which hurt attackers.
Subdermal spikes. Perfect timing tree, thank you.
There's a threat matrix calculator, which gives a high chance to dodge attacks when in light or no armor.
Oh, okay, cool.
Neural contextualizer automatically switched to the right tool.
Based upon what you're looking at?
Yep.
That's a pretty awesome idea.
Consciousness transmitter keeps some XP after death.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Mall Ender rat's... jammer blocks Ender teleportation.
Oh. Mallrat says he likes the derps, D-E-R-P-S. What is that?
That's from his add-on mod, Wired.
Okay.
Let's see, what's he got in here? He's got a cybernetic brain, which increases experience gained from XP orbs, prevents anvils from breaking when used to repair or enchant items. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
And then there's a cybernetic stomach, which is increases in efficiency of consumed foods, allows for the consumption of cyborg food.
All right.
And then there's the DERPS, which is the Dynamic Ender Repositioning System. It uses in-tech to partially negate fall damage.
Oh, okay. That's cool.
And then there's thermo-optical camouflage, which gives you invisibility when you're sneaking.
Okay.
Kinetic dampener blocks incoming projectiles.
Nice.
And it looks like that's all the augments he's actually got. But he's been getting ideas for more.
Yeah, I'm sure everyone's got ideas for stuff. Oh, wow, hey, if only did this.
Well, we have quite the buildup of canola seeds.
Do we? Well,
yeah.
Flip it back over to Otto then, if we've got a whole bunch already in the chest.
Well, we got canola seeds. There's like...
Oh, I'm sorry, you said
almost,
seeds.
Well, there's 4.5 stacks of canola itself.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you said seeds, but I wasn't listening all the way, I guess.
Almost 6 stacks of canola just sitting in this chest over here.
Well, that's cool.
And then we got a full stack and full oil. And now we've only got one fermenting barrel that's still filling up. The other one's completely full.
All right. Actually, Edition's farmer kind of has the same sort of issue where the inputs end up in the outputs. The c- canola seeds into the wrong spot.
Yeah, that gets fixed in a later update.
Oh yeah.
Than what we've got.
I think Vaygrim is hesitant to bump any of the mods until we get some of the other server issues fixed. And I don't blame him one bit. Fewer moving pieces, the better. But I do know a lot of the mods are a couple versions behind. Okay, how many trees do I have here? I need more saplings. Gosh, I've been in such dire need of saplings since like we first started.
Well, make yourself a crook.
You know, we did have some crooks in the storage. You got the remote storage in? Can I borrow it for a second?
I put it back on the hook.
Oh, there you go.
So we have we're currently sitting at 24 blocks of quartz right now.
Oh yeah, that's plenty of quartz.
And we've still got about 6 stacks of soul sand to go through. Oh.
Bone Crick had like one hit left on it. Remember, Machine uses a power suit mod? Did you ever use that?
Yeah, a little bit.
That was pretty cool. I always enjoyed that one. I was just thinking the cybernetics thing kind of reminded me of that. Because with that, you could, like, you know, you'd start off with a basic system and then you'd kind of upgrade things as you went along. Get yourself some better springs and stronger servos and larger batteries and that kind of stuff.
Yep.
I need bone meal. Got it. Just a little bit more of that. Add more or better tiers of fists for better, easier harvesting without a tool. Yeah, that would be cool. Again, back to machine muses, there was you could add options into your the gloves on your suit, I think it was, is what it was. I used to always like the blades, but the little lights are pretty cool too. I don't know if you remember that, Preacher, you could fling out lights.
I remember that.
From your power seat, those little blue lights. Those are pretty cool.
Alright, now I got a blueprint bin and a cyberware engineering table.
Oh, cool. So now... I assume that you take the blueprints and you put it in the engineering table along with all the necessary components to make your augment? Is that the way it works?
Pretty much. You can also use the engineering table to tear down parts.
Oh, so you can like recycle parts from an augment that you don't want?
Yeah, or one that you have a whole bunch of.
Gotcha. Oh, yeah, Mulrad. Mulrad says, I remember that people use the railgun. This is the Machine Muse's modular power suit again. People use the railgun as a cheap, non-flight method of transport. Fire at the ground and jump. Yeah.
I could jump for the win.
I know. That railgun was pretty cool. That was pretty OP, actually, once you got that railgun. Actually, that whole thing. Once you got yourself set up with a couple of basics on that suit, you were pretty much invincible.
All right. You want to come over to the mob farm for a second?
Yeah, sure. What you got going over here?
Well, I'm currently standing on the engineering table. And then right next to it is the blueprint storage. And then right here is the scanner.
Oh, okay.
With so a completed blueprint in it.
That's what takes 20 minutes is the scanner here.
Yep. But open up the engineering table. And click the button that has the hammer.
That looks complicated. Void warranty.
Yeah, void the warranty a few times.
That's pretty funny. So it's basically taking these salvaged cyber eyes and it's taking them apart. That's pretty funny. I'm watching the hammer squash every time I push that button. That's pretty funny. And so they end up popping out nerves and fiber optics and chrome plating out of there. All right. And then these are the parts and pieces you can use to make other stuff.
Yep.
Right. That's cool.
Ta-da! One complete cyber eye.
Oh. Cool.
And now you have it.
Now what do I do with it, though?
That's gonna have to come later. We need a little bit more diamonds to finish up the robo-surgeon.
The robo-surgeon. Now that sounds frightening. So I'm looking at the description for the cyber eyes. Immunity to blindness. Okay. Enables cyber eye upgrades. All right. And that's gonna be like night vision and that kind of stuff, I assume, right? And then uses one power per second. So there's some sort of power supply we have to keep with us once we're augmented.
There's a power supply you have to build into yourself.
Mm.
Like batteries.
Gotcha. Now the tolerance, what does that tolerance cost?
It's how much cyberware you can actually replace yourself with before you just become nothing.
That's funny. All right, that's cool. Where should I put this eyeball here? Oh, you're making the surgery chamber now.
Oh, yeah.
That's pretty awesome.
Now step inside and watch your hat poke through the roof.
Oh, actually, I'm not able to get my camera out of there. I can't see myself. Yeah, I can't see myself out of there. Cool. So you still need to do some more work on the surgery chamber to get it functional?
Yeah, a little bit.
What do you want me to do with this eyeball you gave me?
Put it in the system for right now. But I'm gonna start going through each of these and doing scanning and blueprinting of all of these, and then we can start breaking them down for parts. Or that works too. I was going to say, just put in the refined storage system for now.
Oh, that system. When you said system, that's the system you meant. Yeah. That makes sense. Cool.
What was all that about?
What's that?
It was like you were, you know...
I was just chewing an apple, eating an apple.
It for a second there, it sounded like you were switching it back and forth from your offhand to your regular hand.
Huh, yeah, I don't know. Actually, I was trying to eat it and I wasn't hungry anymore, so maybe that's what it was.
Well, I think that's good enough for this recording.
Yeah. Made some good progress. You got our storage system upgraded, right? And I think you said it's also faster as well. And you've got us started into the cybernetics. That's pretty cool.
Yep.
I can't wait to check out those augments. That'll be pretty awesome. And then we've got our canola production has been sped up.
Yep.
And then eventually, I'll make enough.
Thanks to both you and Ferg.
What's that?
That's thanks to both you and Ferg.
Yeah. Eventually, I'll get enough of this greenhouse glass made to cover this over.
Now, are we going to turn this into an actual greenhouse-looking greenhouse, or are we just going to have this floating glass grid?
I think that we need to make it look for realsies is what we need to do. There needs to be, like, walls and stuff, or something holding it up, anyway.
Yeah, some glass walls, a door.
Yeah.
I mean, we've got Malice's doors.
Yeah, sure.
Right?
Yep. Agreed.
Yeah, we could have a wooden sliding door.
Oh, yeah, that'd be cool. Yeah, the wooden sliding doors, that'd be awesome. I think probably we'd have the where these slabs are here, where our guardrail is right now, that would be like the glass walls or the walls of the greenhouse, right?
Yep.
So there'd still be this walking space around it. Yeah, I think it would work really well. And if I remember right, the actual edition's greenhouse glass, it doesn't... We could lift it up even higher. It doesn't need to be right above the plants like this. I think
it
works as long as there's nothing obstructing it, I think. Oh, we got lots of canola stacking up here. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We got almost 8 stacks of canola stacked up there. That's a pretty good place to be. Oh, thank you for the saplings.
No problem.
All right. Well, yeah, that's pretty cool. I feel good. I think we got a lot of stuff done tonight. And we got a little extra storage too, that's right, because I added another capacitor bank. So we got some extra power storage going. These oak barrels still can't be moved, can they?
Not currently, I don't think.
Yeah, unless we want to like set fire to them or something, right?
Yeah. I don't know. Do you want to check and see if you can break it or not?
I think it tends to crash the game when you do that, right?
I think it only crashes the client, though.
Oh, really? All right, well, if it only crashes the client. I think they wait till I'm done with the stream.
Yeah, I think I'm going to end my recording here.
I like the view from up on top of the mob farm. You can see how everything's kind of spread out and how everything's organized. Hello! I need to learn how to use those emotes. I know we've got that emote mod on here, but I think I need to make some hotkeys for it. Alright. So I think I'm gonna stop the stream here. Actually, it's been about 2 hours, and we got a bunch of stuff done. We've got actually, let me pull down the logo here. We've got some improvements over here with the garden area, so that we've increased our canola growth, our canola crop, our granola, granola. That's what it is. I must be hungry. Our granola crop over there, our canola crop over there. With the addition of some fertilized dirt and starting to get it covered with greenhouse. glass. And then DarkPreacher added an auto hammer to our sieving system over here, which is really cool. So we might be able to then retire the mechanical user auto hammer over here at the other end of the facility. And then maybe eventually move those down actually toward the toward where the triplicator is right now, because that would kind of make logical sense. And then we could turn this whole that whole top platform into a tree farm. Maybe you put some grass out there too, so it'd be kind of a pasture-y kind of area. That could be kind of cool. And then
that would work.
Yeah, it'd be kind of neat, I think. And so the top would all be kind of just mostly sort of agriculture. That could have a neat look to it. And then Preacher updated our refined storage system as well. So we've got increased capacity over there. And if I can peek down over here, he started us off with the cybernetics stuff too. So that's going to be fun once we get all of that up and running, so we can give ourselves some augments. So lots of progress tonight. Actually, there was a pretty big night. There's lots of stuff that we packed in the last couple hours. Good night. So, all right. Well, going to close off the stream here. Thanks, everyone, for joining in the chat room. I certainly appreciate it. I know don't have a lot of chat activity at this hour of the evening, but I'm really appreciative of you dropping in and your interaction here this evening. So I'm going to shut off the stream here at this point, and then the VOD, video on demand, will be available on beam.pro/graylock. And in just a couple of days, I'll also load it on my YouTube channel. I am The Graylock on YouTube. You can check it out there, along with my other Let's Play. I'm doing a Let's Play for a game called Planet Explorers. It's kind of a fun game. I'm actually, I was kind of curious and interested in it, and so I started playing it, and now I'm actually kind of really, really enjoying it. I know that sounds funny that I would say now I'm enjoying it, but yeah, I've had the chance to sort of dig into some of its capabilities. It's a pretty neat little game that was kind of a sleeper. I didn't hear that much about it, and I just started playing it, and it's got some really neat features. So that's called Planet Explorers, and it's one of the other Let's Plays on my channel, so you can check that out. And anyway, thanks again, and we do this Tuesday nights. I do a live stream. The Dark Preacher and Fergcraft will take this and chop it up and make Let's Plays out of it. So be sure to check out their channels as well. Thanks again. Thanks to Tanchi, Mallrat, Greater C, and all of you that that dropped in. Any last closing words, Preach?
I have currently changed up my schedule, so that way VC4 now shows up twice a week on my channel. It's going to start out this week with Monday and Wednesday, and then it's going to go to a Monday and Friday.
All right, Monday and Friday. Cool. Right on. Thanks for that. All right. Thanks again for watching, and check back next Tuesday night for the next Vaygrim's Chance for Season 4, Life in the Buffer Live.